Hey folks, Jordy here for CineCam.net, and welcome to Creative Tuesday, where we think outside of the box and share some exciting filmmaking tips. Now today is going to be all about camera movement, which normally requires expensive gear, but luckily there's Full Sails University, our sponsor today, where you can play around with all of the cinema gear, but that's for later. Let's have a look at 10 very simple camera movements that anyone can do as long as you have a camera. And that's the only thing that you're gonna need. So starting off easy, hold your camera with two hands and press it against your chest or stomach. Now bend a little bit to your knees, which allows you to lean left and right. And this creates a very steady sliding movement. Now I actually used to do that a lot back in the days when cameras were bigger, only then I would lock the camera into my hip. Anyways, next up we're gonna slide over a table. Now hold your camera firmly, but lean on one or multiple fingers as you slide forward or backwards. And this keeps the camera at the same distance towards the table and you get less of a wiggle. A great idea to follow something as it rolls towards the camera or to reveal something as you move forward. Tip number three, which is more of a general tip rather than a specific movement. As you do handheld movements, there's always gonna be some wiggle, but you can reduce that the faster you make those movements. So the idea is to shoot in a slow motion, but also adjust the shutter speed accordingly. Now you just do your movements super fast and you'll get a much more stable shot. Tip number four is a DIY Steadicam. Now the idea is pretty straightforward. You wanna make sure that the camera is hanging. Now for instance, you can attach a bowl head to the hot shoe adapter of your camera and run around holding that. Or you can also use your camera strap like we've shown last year in a video. With some crafting, you can also hook up a stick to your camera and get the same results. Really cool. Tip number five, make use of objects that can make certain movements. For instance, a bar stool. Put your camera on it and you can make a steady pan movement, or a normal office chair can do the same thing. Or if you can find a way to attach your camera to a door, then you can translate the movement of that door to your camera. So look around in your room and see which objects can help you create interesting camera movements. Now one thing is sure, camera movements look very dynamic, but why do we do them and which movements do we choose? Well, that's the role of the cinematographer to understand. And if you don't know where to start, then definitely check out Full Sails University, where you can learn all of the aspects of filmmaking and cinematography either on campus or online. Full Sails Film Bachelor's Degree Program immerses you in the world of filmmaking. You'll gain hands-on experience while learning what's it like to work on a large-scale production from start to finish. You get a feel for the role of each crew member, allowing you to specialize in the ones where your strengths and interests lay. And then there's the Digital Cinematography Online Bachelor's Degree Program, which merges the artistic concepts of traditional filmmaking with the technical tools used in everything from documentary filmmaking to commercial production and web video, preparing you for every role in a small crew production. Now, these degrees are offered in an accelerated format to get you in the field faster, with hands-on projects, industry-experienced faculty, and professional equipment and sets. You'll be prepared to pursue your passion. Now, some of the grads have even gone to work on Bill and Ted Face the Music, The Boys, The Mandalorian, and a lot more. So definitely make sure to check out these film programs. You can learn more on how to get started at filmsale.edu/cinecom, or just simply click the first link in the description down below. And now, let's continue with camera movement number six. Place your camera onto a ball. Press it sturdy against it so that your camera is locked in. We can now roll the ball and get some very interesting movements. I definitely like this sideway movement a lot as it rotates the camera. Trick number seven, the drop. Now be careful doing this one and take any precautions that you can, because yes, we're gonna drop the camera. Now the idea is that you film your subject and suddenly you just drop your camera, and you can tie this together with a movement of the talent where they also fall on the ground or something. You can also take it a step further and shoot a second shot where you drop the camera into someone's hands. Stitching these two shots together can create a very nice transition as well. Camera movement number eight. Most of the camera shake or wiggle comes from walking with the camera. So if you can find a way to move yourself without walking, you basically get a steady shot. You can use things like rollerblades, which are actually used quite often in the film industry, together with a gimbal. Or a skateboard, which I personally feel more comfortable with. That's all part of the trick. And then there is the famous office chair, or simply filming outside of a car, although this only works when the pavement is smooth, or you just have an incredible suspension. Here's another idea, wear thick socks and slide over the floor. Use your creativity, guys, to find different ways to move yourself without walking. And this brings us to trick number 9, which I'm gonna be honest about. It's kinda similar like the tripod trick video we did not too long ago, where we created a DIY jib. Well, I did want to include it here again, as you can also pull that same camera movement off without a tripod. Simply attach your camera to a long but sturdy pole, place it onto a chair or something, and add a counterweight to balance everything. This allows you to move up and down, but make sure that you always hold your camera securely as you do so. And this brings us to the last camera movement, which is probably the first camera hack that I've ever pulled off. This was in my first year at film school. We weren't allowed to loan out any other equipment other than a camera as a freshman, but I really wanted to add like a lift movement into one of the shots of my short film, so I came up with the following idea. What I did was clamp my camera to a skateboard, and then I would lean into the wall with that skateboard and push the camera up. It turned out pretty good, and I still think it's an amazing camera movement. Now, you are gonna need a skateboard for this, or perhaps something else with wheels under it, but yeah. Definitely try it if you can. And those were my 10 camera movements on a budget. Movements, what was that? Anyways, I hope that you've learned something new, and if you wish to learn even more, then don't forget to check out Full Sail University. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Full Sail, for the support. And as always, stay creative. Ah!